Hey, PPA, it's Heidi Allen, founder of the Positive People Army. Happy Thursday! Oh, yes, it's Thursday. I'm here in Toronto, Canada. It's going to be a super hot day here. I'm serious. It's like we literally went from 3 seconds of spring to, oh my God, it's summer, which is fantastic, and I absolutely love it. I hope all of you are enjoying some incredible weather for Think About It Thursday. Think About It Thursday is such an incredible day and such an incredible message because it's always about stuff that we're thinking about, or maybe we should step back for a second and think about it. So today what I want to talk about is a word I want us to think about is labels. We all put labels on ourselves, we put labels on other people, we put labels on things that we do. And so I really want us to focus in on exactly what some of the labels are that we're giving ourselves. Because sometimes these labels that we're giving ourselves actually can be harmful against us. They can prevent us from succeeding. They can prevent us from going after our dreams. They can sometimes hurt relationships, or relationships might not grow because of the labels we're giving. So for instance, you're probably thinking, Heidi, what on earth are you even talking about? I'm talking about, say, for instance, what about something just as innocent as I'm an unlucky person. Sometimes people say that. You may have said that about yourself. You may have heard other people say that when they're like, oh my gosh, I'm just so unlucky. And it's like, we have to be careful about some of the things that we're putting out there and we're saying, like, I'm an unlucky person. Because if you say that, you're going to believe that. And you know the way that, you know, we talk here in the PPA, and you know what I believe in, that the universe is like a magic genie. And the magic genie says, okay, your wish is my command. So if you're labeling yourselves with things that maybe can be harmful, it's time to take a step back and really start looking at these particular labels. Hello, Sabrina. Hi, Steve. Hi, Marion. Good morning, Andrew. I hope everyone is really well today. Like I said, it's a fabulous Thursday here. And today for Think About Thursday, we're talking about labels. So I wanted to tell you guys a very personal story that I went through when my eldest son, Michael, was turning 18 years old. He's now 22. So this was a couple of years ago. And with Michael, when he was turning 18, just like any 18-year-old, you start to, sometimes with your parents, you start to do this a little. So with him, you know, I'm like going about my role as his mother the only way I know how, which is, you know, managing his life. This is what I have done for so long. And all of a sudden, Michael and I were kind of arguing back and forth, and he blurted out to me, "You're not the boss of me anymore." And I was like, huh, I'm not the boss of you anymore. It made me step back for a second. Not only did it make me step back, but it made me step back and really questioned our relationship and what this dynamic now was. Hey guys, are you just noticing my cute little cat right here? This is Lucy. Lucy! Lucy, say hi. That's Miss Lucy. She's very old and she can be very ornery. I'm not joking you. I'm about the only one she really loves in this house. We have two dogs as well, so the cat's mine. But anyway, I even questioned everything about us and our relationship. So for a couple of weeks, I'm not gonna lie, guys, like it was really hard to hear those words from my son, because of course, as you know, if anyone has kids out there, you know what it feels like to have children, and for them to say something like that, it's hurtful. So I was really upset about this, and I finally brought it up with my husband, and I said, you know, I feel like I'm losing Michael. I feel like I'm losing him. And he said to me, oh my gosh, Heidi, you'll never lose Michael. The two of you are so incredibly close, but I just kind of feel that maybe you gotta change your label. And I was like, change my label? What? So I really sat with this. I journaled about it. I really thought about it. What does that mean? So here's the thing. All along throughout Michael's life, since the time he was born, I was the boss, the manager of his life. In the beginning, I chose the food he ate, the clothes that he wore, you know, the extracurricular activities he took, the schools he went to, you know, all of the experiences that he should have, the vacations. That was my job. I was the manager and the boss of his life. But all of a sudden, Michael now, he wasn't comfortable with that label or that title that I had. And now neither was I, because it wasn't working. Because now he was going into adulthood. So I finally decided, after, you know, a lot of thought about this, that I was going to retire my label as the manager of his life, the boss of his life. And I was going to take a new label that was, I am now the consultant of Michael's life. I can sit back and enjoy him and enjoy his life, but it is up to him now to make the decisions. It's up to him to go on this journey. And I will always be here as the consultant when he needs my advice, my opinions. He wants to talk about something. I'll always be here. I just have a different label. So see how just a simple shift in the way I labeled myself changed everything about our dynamic. Our dynamic is completely different now. We function as that, you know, Michael and his mom. I'm the consultant and he is on his own journey doing what it is that he is supposed to do. And it did. It made such an incredible difference in our life. So what I want you to do, Army, is I want you to really start thinking about the labels that you are giving yourself. And I want you to ask yourself with these labels, are they fact or are they just my perspective and my interpretation of something? Because for instance, there's so many people that, you know, they walk around. I have this incredible girlfriend who actually said to me one day, this woman, no word of a lie, she has 3 kids, a full-time job, her kids are in tons of extracurricular activities, she works out on a regular basis, she's super social, she hosts dinner parties and stuff all the time. And she actually said to me, she labeled herself, oh my gosh, I'm just so disorganized. And I said to her, in what way? In what way are you disorganized? And she said, oh my God, I just feel like I'm coming and going. I'm like, sweetheart, what you're labeling yourself as disorganized is actually not a fact that's happening here. And I pointed out all of those amazing things that she does on a daily basis, a weekly basis, a monthly basis. And I said, you're not disorganized, but maybe there is a label that you're putting on yourself that's making you give yourself the other label of disorganized. Maybe you're trying to live a label that's, you know, I'm super mom, I'm superhuman, I'm, you know, a perfectionist, one of those. So sometimes we need to step back and wonder, are some of those labels putting too much pressure on us? How many of you out there are that person in your family where you're always saying, well, I'm the responsible one, I can't do that. I'm the strong one in this relationship, whatever it is. And sometimes those hurt us, because when we are hurting or we need help or assistance, being the strong one, the responsible one, all of a sudden you feel like you can't, you're putting so much pressure on yourself. So PPA, I want you to really think about it. So think about it Thursday. I want you to really think about these labels that you're putting on yourself. One, are they fact or just your perception or interpretation? Ask friends and family that you trust. Tell them these things. You know, are you that person? Are you also labeling yourself with something like, I'm always late? Think about it. Your wish is my command, is what the universe says. So really wonder and think about all of those labels that we're putting on ourselves. Is it something that's too much pressure? Is it actually not even fact? Really stand back, and you're going to start to notice now. Guys, you're going to start to notice these labels that you have on yourself. You're going to start to say them and go, huh, am I really that person, or do I want to be that person? So think about it. That's what Think About Thursday is about. I want you guys to really think about these things and really just, we can shift the way we're doing things. Just like I shifted my label from being the manager of Michael's life to the consultant. It shifted our relationship. It shifted the way I think about things with the two of us, and you can do the exactly same thing. What did Andrew just say? Sorry, I'm like reading this. What did you say, Andrew? How about work in progress? You know what? It's not, how about just say I am, instead of that you're working towards something. That's something, Andrew. So I had a really great person, Victoria, that's one of our core founders here in the group. She taught me to divorce myself from the word will. I will do that. Because what happens is every time you're constantly saying something is in the future, it only ever exists in the future. It doesn't exist. Your affirmations and things that you really want to happen in your life need to happen right now. So it is happening. I am progress. That's what you need to change that to. Make sure you're constantly not divorce yourself from will. Divorce yourself from everything exists in the future. It happens here in the present. Okay, guys, that was Think About It Thursday. I hope it really makes you guys think about things. It really makes you think about some of the labels that you're putting on yourself. I want everyone to get outside today, especially if you are in Toronto. It is a fantastic day. Share with me how it is in your city, your country, wherever you are. I'd love to hear that. Guys, adore you all. Thank you so much for joining me. Have a great day.